Greyhound News Network. This is Pope TV. And please stand for the Pledge of the Flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now, for a moment of silence.
Welcome to the Greyhound News Network. I'm Kate Green.
And I'm Siani Robine.
And this is Pope TV. Thank you to all the Pope teachers. We want to wish every teacher a very happy Teacher Appreciation Week.
Congratulations to Matthew Ralph, who was elected Student of the Month for April by Pope's faculty. He won a Chick-fil-A gift card.
Ambassador applications for the 23-24 school year are open. To qualify, you must be a rising junior or senior who is kind and willing to wow the rising freshman with Pope's spirit. Applications can be found outside Miss Hebert's room in 103. Applications are due back on Friday, May 5th. Have any questions? Stop by and talk to either Miss Hebert or Miss Sims.
Hi, my name is Jackson Lee. I'm reporting for GNN here, and today we're going to take a deep dive on head nutrition specialist Tanya Dampier and what her and her staff do. I got the chance to sit down and talk with Ms. Dampier about the inner workings of the school cafeteria at Pope High School.
My name's Tanya Dampier, and I am the cafeteria manager at Pope High School.
How long have you been working at Pope?
This year will make 7 years.
How do you guys prepare the food in such vast amounts for the students?
So we have prepared recipes that help us to calculate the different amounts. For example, if we're going to make 300 servings of a pasta dish, we have a recipe and a calculator, a recipe that automatically calculates for us how much of each ingredient we're going to need.
How does it make you feel that some of the students may not enjoy the food like you do?
It actually makes me feel more interested to find out why the students don't enjoy the food. And if there are students that don't enjoy the food, like for example, if you tasted something and you did not like it, I would be interested for you to come back and let us know why you didn't like it and different ways, give us different feedback on how we could make it more to your liking.
Seems that Ms. Dampier and her staff would love to know if any of you students have anything to say about their food or ways they can improve it. I'm Jackson Lee, reporting for GNN.
Attention Pope students. Pope Football Boosters are hosting a t-shirt design competition for next year's Matt Hobby football game. Pause your screen to review the design requirements and scan the QR code for additional information and to submit your designs. Posters are hung around the school with the QR code as well. The winning design gets a free t-shirt. Submissions will close on Friday, May 12th, so get your designs in soon, Greyhounds.
Friday morning biscuits are back. Come support FCCLA in the culinary department as they sell fresh, hot, steamy Chick-fil-A biscuits Friday mornings for $4 on Main Street. Get them while they're hot, and thanks for the support.
And now to the sports.
And Anthony, in the morning,
and now the sports.
It's state playoff season. Baseball, tennis played last night, and lacrosse teams play tonight. Come out and support your fellow Greyhounds.
The baseball team split their series with Woodstock on Saturday. In game one, Carson Curtis had a bomb, an RBI, and a stolen base. With Carson's stolen base in game one, he becomes Pope Baseball's all-time stolen base leader with 44 career stolen bases. Congratulations, Carson. Eli Overstreet had a triple and Jack Myers had a double. In game two, Blythe Kiesler pitched six innings with six strikeouts and picked up the win on the mound. Carson Curtis was 2-for-3 with a double, an RBI, and he picked up the save. Hounds were back in action last night at Woodstock. Don't have the results yet, but we'll be back on Friday to get y'all updated.
Congratulations to the girls' soccer team on a fantastic season. The ladies finished the season as region champs in a Final Four finish. We are so proud of our girls, and we thank you for your hard work and dedication this season, and a special high five to our seniors that have been so successful for the last 4 years.
The boys' tennis team played yesterday in the third round of the state playoffs at Marist. Results coming soon.
Congratulations to the girls' lacrosse team. They had a wonderful season. Thank you, girls, for all of your hard work and dedication, especially our seniors. Thank you for 4 years of success.
Congratulations to our boys' lacrosse team. The guys beat Alpharetta on Saturday, 12-7. Our guys are on a roll. Next up, they're playing in the third round of state playoffs tomorrow night at Roswell at 7 p.m. Make your plans to take the short ride over to Roswell to cheer on the guys.
Our boys and girls track teams are running hot off the girls' runner-up and boys' region champion performances last week. Good luck at sectionals on Saturday. Run fast, jump high, and throw far.
That's it for the sports. Back to you guys.
Thank you, guys. Are you looking for service hours? You can earn hours by setting up testing locations for the AP exams. There are 6 different dates to choose from. You may work one day or all 6. Please see Mrs. White in room 105 to sign up. And if you have signed up for AP testing setup for any of the days, please see Mr. Green and Ms. Wallace in the PAC lobby at 3:45 p.m. on the day you signed up to work.
Did you know that 21 million children in the United States receive a free or reduced lunch price during the school year? For a lot of those children, a school lunch is the only full meal they have every day. During the summer, that guaranteed meal goes away and millions of children go hungry or food insecure. How can you help? Donate dry and canned goods to our Must Ministries food drive now through May 11th. Bring all your donations to your first period class. The first period with the most items collected will win a donut party the week of May 15th, sponsored by the POC Student Alliance. Every donation helps a child in need.
Riding along in my automobile, my baby beside me at the wheel. I stole a kiss at the turn of a mile, my curiosity running wild. Cruising and playing the radio with no particular place to go. Riding along in my automobile, I was anxious to tell her the way I feel. So I told her softly and sincere, and she leaned and whispered in my ear. Cuddling more and driving slow with no particular place to go. Place to go. So we parked way out on the Kokomo.
FCA will have a meeting this Friday at 7:45 in the Greyhound Theater. Come and enjoy the fun, fellowship, a wonderful speaker, and breakfast.
Did you know that the Greyhound News Network is always online for your viewing at www.greyhoundnews.net? Log in from your phone or at home 24/7.
We are the GNN. Thank you for watching the Greyhound News Network.
Have a great day, Greyhounds.